So what do you think is the next logical step in the Saturn research?
I think it's following up on the discoveries made by Cassini, doing the science Cassini wasn't equipped to do. And a good example of that is Enceladus. We know Enceladus has a global liquid water ocean. Right. That ocean is salty. There's hydrothermal vents on the seafloor. And so going back and saying, okay, the conditions are right for life, but there's no instruments on board Cassini to make that assessment.
So tantalizing.
So go back, take the free samples you're getting and fly through those jets and sample them and do the measurements to determine, you know, what's the ocean characteristics like? Could there possibly be life? And at some point, maybe go back and collect a sample and bring it back to the Earth and then leverage all the things you could do. Bring it back to the Earth carefully in case there are microbes there and study it here on the ground.
Yeah, that's great. Do you still have the same level of curiosity about Saturn now as you did when you first started this? Did it become so commonplace to see all these discoveries coming through that you got a little, you know, used to it or jaded?
I don't think I ever got jaded. The discoveries were so incredible and so remarkable. If anything, I think I'm even more curious about so many questions that we now have from Cassini about Enceladus, about Titan, about the rings, Saturn itself, its giant magnetosphere. So many questions. I really want to go back.
Tell me about the New Frontiers Initiative.
Well, NASA has an initiative called New Frontiers, and they have a set number of missions to which you could write proposals. And after Cassini's tremendous discoveries, you know, Titan II has a liquid water ocean, it has these methane lakes and seas, and astrobiologists wonder, could you have a really unusual kind of life in the seas of Titan? So they added Enceladus and Titan to the list, and so there are now a series of objectives, of which now these two ocean worlds are a part. And so fairly soon, this December, NASA will take those 12 mission proposals, down select to three or four, ask the teams to spend the next year writing a really comprehensive end-to-end proposal, and then I think sometime like maybe June 2019, make the final selection. Which mission do they pick? And will it be one to go back to Saturn? Right. Because there's a Saturn probe mission in the mix too, so five of the 12.
I see.
Two Enceladus, two Titan, one probe into Saturn's atmosphere. So we got five chances out of 12 to go back.
That's pretty good odds, I would think.